Would you rather be a busy person with endless things on your to-do list, or would you be a productive person who finds the time to enjoy things beyond work and routine chores? If you picked option 2, stay with me. Do not try to overwhelm your brain by trying to remember everything on a daily basis. It is not humanly possible to recollect everything that you wanted to do. Maintain two separate to-do lists, one personal and one official. When you make this to-do list, start from the most important task. Prioritize, write down your list, so that the next day, as soon as your day starts, you know where to begin and what to do. If you are not a pen and paper kind of a person, you can have this to-do on your phone itself. I am slightly inclined to recommend the pen and paper method, because every time you go back to your phone to check your to-do, there is also a chance that you will be distracted by all the notifications waiting for you. Always start with the high priority task in your list. We often start with the most easiest of tasks because crossing items from our to-do list gives us so much joy. But if you notice, you will see how these little tasks keep coming as the day progresses. And in order to cross as many items as possible from the list, we spend the entire day doing these little tasks. We spend so much time in perfecting the details of that little task, and at the end of the day, that one major task goes undone and the cycle continues. This is why you feel that you haven't done enough, even though you might be working all day long. So from next time, start with the high priority tasks, and you will be amazed to see how these little or easy tasks can be accommodated even at the last hour in your day. One common complaint that we all have is that we don't find enough time to pursue a hobby, to read a book, or to do things that we really like, because most of us hardly find any time after our regular chores or our routine work. This is where making use of that downtime can make all the difference. For instance, you can listen to an audiobook while you are doing the prep work for cooking, or while walking, or while you are on your way to office. You can also do your routine chores such as online grocery shopping or paying bills while you are traveling. So making use of this downtime to do your routine chores or to learn something new can save a lot of time than you can imagine. Start delegating the tasks. Don't push yourself too harder. Let's assume you have your own team at office and you still think none of them can do something as good as you. You are failing as a manager. You have to delegate tasks and get things done from them instead of doing it all by yourself. Same thing applies to your home situation too. Especially when you are doing the routine chores, divide the chores so that no one person in the house feels exhausted and stressed at the end of the day. It is no secret that a lot of us waste a huge amount of time checking our phones and social media. In one of our earlier videos, we spoke about how we can schedule these distractions for the most unproductive period of your day. Besides scheduling the distractions, you can also do yourself a favor by deleting the apps that don't add any value to your productivity. When you are doing something important, put your phone in silent or airplane mode. Turn off all the notifications for the apps as much as you can, especially the retail apps. Even if we don't intend to buy anything, we get the joy just browsing through the latest arrivals as soon as a notification pops up. And even before you realize, you would have ended up wasting hours browsing through these apps. It's not your work if it's not your work. I know this is not simple, but you have to learn to start saying no if it's not your work. Personal favors are okay as long as it does not consume your productive time. Similarly, choose your work assignments wisely. Don't bite more than what you could chew. There's always a polite way of saying no without hurting or offending someone. Just learn how to do it. No matter how full your plate is, remember to take effective breaks. If you've been working from home since morning, reward yourself with a little TV time or to do anything that you enjoy. If you're in office, go for a quick coffee with your colleagues. Have a small chat with them. Just get up and move from the place. This is to unwind and get back to work. What are some of your tips to manage time? Let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. For more such videos, subscribe to Mace Winner's channel and hit that bell notification. I post videos every Thursday. Until we meet next week, bye and be well.